Hare Krishna. Question. In the Bhagavad Gita 9.32, does Papa Yonaya refer to a fourth category apart from Striya, Vaishya and Shudra? Or is it an adjective that describes the three categories listed later? Prabhupada translates it as an adjective describing, but I have heard that it can also be translated as four distinct categories. Can you give a clear understanding of this? Answer: yes, in his translation of the Gita, Prabhupada translates that as apayonaya, as addressing all three other categories. But Prabhupada, in several places elsewhere in his lectures and in his books, he generally translates papayonaya as referring to those who are lower than Shudras. So there is the Varanashram, and those who are outside the Varanashram system, those who are outcast, they are considered to be a sinful birth. Now, to be born in a place where Varanashram is there, that itself indicates that one has done some punya in the past, because of which one has got birth within Varanashram. So one who does not get birth within Varanashram is considered to be Papa Yonaya. So for example, Prabhupada, so there is a lot of research that has been done on this subject by different devotees. So we have one of my devotee friends is called Hariparshit Prabhu, who has compiled the commentaries of over a dozen acharyas on this topic, and I have put the link for that and the question answer on my site. Link to his Facebook page, and along with that, there also we will discuss about acharya's commentaries, but let's focus on Prabhupada. So another devotee scholar, Revati Vallabh Prabhu, he has compiled a set of Prabhupada's quotes which show how actually the Prabhupada refers to Papa Yonaya. Prabhupada says that women are not Papa Yonaya. Actually, Papa Yonaya are those who are lesser than Shudra. So for example, Prabhupada quotes 7.7.16 purport, he says that, so even though a woman may not be Papa Yonaya, because of being less intelligent, she sometimes forgets devotional instructions. And then in several lectures, Prabhupada says, Papa Yoni means less than Shudras. They are considered as Chandalas, less than Shudras. So essentially the point is, they are, Papa Yoni generally means less than Shudras. So now Prabhupada also quotes this verse from the Bhagavatam 2.4.18, that Kirata Hunandra Pulinda Pulkasha Abhir Shumbha Yavana Kasadaya. That ennecha papashrayasya shuddhyanti tasmai prabhavishnave nama, that people who may be very very sinful, if they take shelter of the Lord, then they can get liberated and they can attain the supreme destination. So if they can take shelter of the Lord through his devotees, shuddhyanti tasmai prabhavishnave, to that Lord who can purify everyone, I offer my obeisances. So the point is that Papa Yonaya as a fourth category can also be taken, and there are Prabhupada's quotes which support that also, that translation also. Now actually this translation also makes more sense, because Vaishyas are not considered Papa Yonaya generally. Vaishyas are those who are vijas. Now they are giving second initiation also, and they are allowed to eventually study the Vedas in the traditional Vedic culture. So in that sense, the Dvijas are, the Vaishyas are not really Papa Yonayas. Now, that means Prabhupada gives one translation of Papa Yonaya as a describer for all three, but elsewhere he talks of Papa Yonaya as referring to those who are outside Varanashram. And from the context also, we see that he generally refers to Papa Yonaya as those who are Kirat, Manandra, Pulindra, Kapilkasha, outside Varanashram, generally speaking. Now, going beyond this, we have the commentaries of the previous Acharyas. Now, previous Acharyas have also given a wide variety of commentaries on this. Some commentators like Shankaracharya and Ramanacharya, they use Papa Yonaya as a describer for the other three categories, but then they don't give any reason why Vaishyas are considered to be Papa Yonaya. In fact, no commentator has commented why Vaishyas should be considered as Papa Yonaya, except for one commentator who says that they also have to lie. and that's why they are mentioned, given special mention over here, but not that they are called Papa Yonaya. Now, in our tradition, both Baldev Vidya Bhushan and Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur, they treat these four as separate categories. That means Papa Yonaya are a fourth category, and Striya Vaishya Shudra, they are different categories. So Striya Vaishya Shudra are not Papa Yonaya, according to both Baldev Vidya Bhushan and Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur. And similarly, there are other commentators also, Madhusudan Saraswati and then Sridhar Swami. They also, Madhusudan Saraswati especially, he supports this same point also. And Madhusudan Saraswati is quite often quoted by Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur in his commentary also. And is interestingly, Abhinav Gupta has also written a commentary in which he actually says Papa Yonaya refers to other species, not even human beings. And he says Bhakti is so potent that even non-human beings can be delivered, and he used the example of Gajendra for that. So now Prabhupada himself told us that verses can be translated in different ways. And as long as the Siddhanta is maintained, different translations can be accepted. So Papa Yonaya can be accepted as referring to a fourth category of people, those who are outside of Varnashram. And that is also compatible with our tradition, with the broad philosophy that the tradition teaches, and it is also compatible with Prabhupada's teachings when he uses and defines Papa Yonaya elsewhere. Thank you. Hare Krishna.